Now, remember that it is God doing his work through you. And because it is God doing his work through you, he will be there. We've seen how the Lord said that when they arrest you, don't bother to think about what you would say or what you would do. Don't worry. Don't even rehearse anything. Don't say, when I stand before the king or the judge, this is what I'm going to say. Don't even premeditate anything. When you get there, God will open your mouth and God himself will begin to speak through you. In Acts chapter 6, verse 10, we see the evidence that the Holy Spirit was with Stephen. In verse 10, it says, and they were not able to resist the wisdom and the spirit by which he spoke. Why? It was the Spirit of God speaking through Stephen, a man full of grace and truth and of the power of the Holy Spirit. In verse 15, the Bible tells us that when they set Stephen before the council, as they were looking at him, what did they see? They saw his face as the face of an angel. The Holy Spirit was there, showing that you are about to deal with something that you don't even understand. And in any case, in Isaiah chapter 63, verse 9, the Bible tells us, Isaiah 63, verse 9, that in all their afflictions, he, the Lord, was also afflicted. So whatever you are going through, Christ is going through it. Remember, you are in Christ and Christ is in you. So whatever they do to you, they are doing to him. You will recall that when the Lord Jesus Christ appeared to Saul of Tarsus on the road to Damascus, he said to him, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? And Saul said, who are you that I'm persecuting? He said, the church that you're persecuting, that's me. I am the church. So please understand this. It's nothing personal. It's the Lord Jesus Christ that they are after, and you are his own. You cannot say that I belong to Jesus. I belong to Jesus only when good things are happening. And then when things are going awry, you begin to wonder, what is this I belong to Jesus that I'm even shouting about? What is he paying me? That is the problem with the kind of prosperity gospel that's been preached. It doesn't prepare you for this kind of thing. And it's going to happen. It will have nothing to do with government. You know, I hear people shout, oh, they want to Islamize Nigeria, they want to Islamize Nigeria. If they were going to Islamize Nigeria, do you think you will have the voice to speak? Do you think it's only Nigeria? You will run elsewhere. They will pursue you there. You will not be able to escape it. So let's stop lending the voice that God has given to us to politicians who are just looking for a way of getting what they cannot get from their field the way they ought to get it. Colossians chapter 1, verse 24 to 29. Paul writes here, says, I now rejoice in my sufferings for you. Look at Paul saying, this is the attitude. I'm rejoicing in my sufferings for you and fill up in my flesh what is lacking in the afflictions of Christ for the sake of his body, which is the church. So in the place of Christ, Christ ought to physically be here suffering, but I am taking that position. Of course, Christ was in him. So I'm taking that position and he's suffering for the Christ, for the church through me. Even though I'm also suffering, but he is bearing the brunt of it. Verse 25, of which I became a minister according to stewardship from God, which was given to me for you to fulfill the word of God, the mystery which has been hidden from ages and from generations, but now has been revealed to his saints. To them, God willed to make known what are the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Him we preach, warning every man and teaching every man in all wisdom, that we may present every man perfect in Christ Jesus. To this end, I also labor, striving according to his working, which works in me mightily. So, Paul is not saying that I'm doing it because I'm so. No, it's because Christ is in me. The gospel I'm preaching is to let you know that Christ is in you. And so because Christ is in us, that is what Satan is seeing and commanding his proteges to come after us. Ordinarily, when they look at us, they don't hate us. But because they have Satan in them and we have Christ in us and both are sworn enemies. Remember what God said in Genesis chapter 3. He said, the seed of the woman shall bruise the head of Satan, of the serpent. And serpent, the serpent shall bite the heel, what actually should be the Achilles heel, of, that's the vulnerable part, of the seed of the woman. We are all of the seed of the woman, because once we come into Christ, we are all of Christ. And all those who are not of Christ are all of Satan. That's why the Bible, that's why the Lord Jesus Christ said, the world will hate you because they are of Satan. So I don't know why we expect the world to like you.